Their lives were shattered on the Hume Highway, and today the parents of a young crash victim took their pain and grief to the steps of State Parliament. In one of the largest petitions in the state's history, they're pleading for urgent upgrades to dangerous breakdown lanes.
3 months to the day since the crash that devastated two families, they assembled to fight for a legacy.
As a measure of the size of the response, Peter.
23,000 signatures demanding the victims be honoured with urgent changes to the state's breakdown lanes.
1,000 for every year of my daughter's life.
23-year-old Sarah Fraser was killed by a passing truck after she broke down on the Hume Highway. The tow truck driver, who'd stopped to help her, was also killed instantly. Jeff Clark, a husband and father of four.
The fact that it's taken these tragic deaths to galvanise people is, I just think, unbelievably regrettable. But coming out of it, hopefully, we'll see some kind of fortitude from the government.
There are two key legislative demands. Where possible, roads and highways be reconfigured to provide 2.5-metre breakdown lanes, and the drivers who see emergency lights be forced to halve their speed and move to an adjacent lane. An audit is underway to estimate the scheme's cost.
It is no longer morally acceptable to sacrifice people's safety by placing them in harm's way for an extra lane of pavement.
All too frequently, there isn't sufficient room to actually move over and park.
As well as the overwhelming support from emergency services and the business community, this road safety push has also proved irresistible within the walls of Parliament. In just over 2 months, more than 30 state and federal ministers have signed on.
The petition will be debated in coming weeks. Matt Doran, 10 News.